In 2020, as the pandemic took hold, U.S. health insurance companies declared they would cover 100% of the cost for COVID treatment, waiving co-pays and expensive deductibles for hospital stays. But this year, most insurers have reinstated co-pays and deductibles for COVID patients, in many cases, even before vaccines became widely available.
Joining us on the KOGO News Live line, Paul Siegert, who is managing partner at PCS Advisers. So explain why insurance companies decided to do this.
Well, the reason they did it in the first place was, it's kind of an interesting story. They were facing the almost certainty that they would have to give back a bunch of premium because of the way the rules work. They have to spend 85 cents for every dollar they collect in premium on claims or refund it. And because everyone was locked down and not going to seek care, they were going to have to give money back anyway. They were also facing the likelihood that the federal government would require them to cover people's expenses entirely related to COVID. So they spent the money to do that rather than give it back and avoid a federal requirement by doing it voluntarily. And that gave them the freedom to decide when to stop. And that has come about this year as claims came back to a more normal level.
More normal level. So that means what kind of bills are people seeing that are being treated for COVID?
Well, it is a pretty much a guaranteed way if you're hospitalized for COVID to hit your max out of pocket. So that'll vary depending on the plan that you're on. But the gross charges that we see, if you have a complicated COVID case, are over $300,000. After discounts, it ends up being about $100,000 in terms of the total cost. Even a case that isn't as severe but does require oxygen, it'd be $150,000. So then when you look at what you have to pay as a consumer, you need to look at that plan and see, okay, what is my max out of pocket? Unfortunately, lots of plans in this post-Affordable Care Act era have max out of pockets that are $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000. And the consumer could be footing that bill.
So let's talk about the consumer who is footing that bill. What do you do if you get stuck with a huge medical bill after a complicated COVID case?
Well, many, unfortunately, are going to be in the position where they're going to have to work with that facility and figure out a payment plan. And that's kind of a bigger story to me pre-COVID, and this is putting a spotlight on it, is the fact that we're spending more than we ever have for insurance that covers less than it ever has. You've got just, I think, about a week-old statistic here the Wall Street Journal put out. Insured Americans are already holding $141 billion in medical debt because of these crazy high-deductible and max-out-of-pocket plans that we're on. So it puts a lot of people in a position of having to go on a payment plan or use a credit card to pay that bill, which I certainly wouldn't, you know, advocate. I think the payment plan, of the two, if you have to do one, work with that facility, and they would almost certainly put you on a payment plan with that obligation that you have.
If you can't do it, I mean, would it default to Medicaid, or is that not an option?
That's kind of also an interesting part of the story. It doesn't affect everyone equally, the situation that we're talking about today. If you're on some form of government-provided insurance, you're not going to be facing these out-of-pocket costs. Largely, it's going to fall on those who are on an employer-sponsored plan or an individual plan that is not Medicaid.
Interesting.
Okay. Mm. So now, does any of this cost blow back? Like, you know, if you're on Medicaid and you're not paying for that, does this blow back on taxpayers?
Well, absolutely. I mean, ultimately, that bill does trickle all the way back to the taxpayers, without a doubt. But what I can also say is that costs overall to the system, these insurers have done really well throughout COVID. The cost of COVID in treating people for COVID have been smaller than the cost they avoided by people not being able to go and get the normal care that they would get. Some of that is showing back up in the system, but a lot of it won't. So you have, if you look at United and the Blues and Cigna and Aetna and Humana and all the big insurers that we're familiar with, they all posted, for the most part, significantly higher profits coming off of COVID than before. So they've done really well.
Paul Siegert, managing partner at PCS Advisers. Interesting information. Thank you so much.